I don't know what it is about Call of Duty recently, but everything just always seems like it's coming soon, it's coming soon, it's on the way, coming soon, this and that. I am so tired of having things delayed that, you know, should be automatically in the game when it comes out. And if you guys didn't know already, league play for Black Ops 4 has been delayed yet again. Unfortunately, this is like the second time it's happened. This time they announced that league play is going to be coming out mid-February, but Treyarch did say in a blog post that they've pretty much revamped the entire mode by adding new rule sets and how the ranking system is going to work. So we are going to be talking about that in a second here. But first off, guys, like I said earlier, I'm just super, super frustrated that things that should be already in the game when it comes out are getting delayed, or they're just not even in the game. Like that's very, very frustrating, because some of this stuff is what I look forward to playing the most in COD. But all I can say is league play better be very, very good for having to wait this long. Anyways, guys, in the blog post, Treyarch does say that they've revamped the mode's rule sets to fit the current rules of today's competitive standards. Plus, they listened to feedback for the ranking system and how it should work. And now this is how a new progressive ranking system is going to work across all players for league play. And they say, over the course of your competitive career, you'll advance a permanent rank that will reflect your performance across all events. Performing better in events and participating more often will result in faster rank progression. Final placement in ladders determines how you'll advance your overall rank, giving ladder events a competitive tournament feel, with the most credit given for reaching first place and winning a league play event. Place first in a league play event and your rank will be upgraded to permanently reflect your victory. Further upgrades are possible for multiple first place finishes over time, and a streak indicator that is displayed when you place first in back-to-back events. Matchmaking in the World League Hub will always be prioritized by skill, so competitors will feel competitive at their skill level. And so yeah, guys, I really do think this ranking system is better than before. Also, one of the biggest concerns were having like 3 to 4 days to pretty much get ranked, but now they have increased the event time to an entire week. So I really do like that change a lot. Plus, when you play league play, of course, you're gonna be earning multiplayer XP and black market tier progressions, which is a really nice touch. But also what I really love the most is this new World League Gauntlets, which I did make a video on it before in the past, and I'm gonna link that down below in the description in case you guys wanna go just check that out. But pretty much you just run the gauntlet, you play a certain amount of games, and based off of how you play, you can earn some in-game prizes. That's kind of like a little short summary of how the gauntlet is set up. Also, you will have the opportunity to play scrims, which are pretty much just unranked games of competitive Black Ops 4. Now, for the rule sets, they did update them, like I said, and here they are on screen. Ajax has been fully restricted, Nomad has been fully restricted, Torque has been fully restricted, Prophet's Seeker Drone has been restricted, Firebreak's Reactor Core, Seraph's Tac Deploy, and then for the Score Streaks, the Dart and the RCXD are banned. And then they also say that Zero's Ice Pick and EMP Disruptor are banned. Plus, future specialists are not going to be allowed to be used in competitive play. However, they do say, though, that if the people in the CWO organization deem them viable, then they will probably make them live. But I don't think that's going to be happening. I think every new specialist from here on out is going to be banned. And that's kind of unfortunate, too, because I feel that it could add more variety for sure. And more multiplayer fans would like to see more specialists in the game, like, you know, the new incoming fans. I don't know, but it is what it is. I just really want league play to be functional. I want it to work. I want it to be very, very fun. And from these new updates, it does sound like it's good. But we'll have to wait and see what happens. On paper, like I said, it does sound good, but we have to wait and see what happens with the rule sets and everything like that, how it's going to play. The rest of the blog post kind of discusses how they came to the conclusion of how they want to set up the rules, set up the ranking system, and base it versed off of the Black Ops 2 league play, which a lot of people thought were the golden boy child, whatever, of league play in Call of Duty history. But I don't know, on paper, this does sound good. I just really want league play, man. I really want to play competitive Black Ops 4. I've been dying to do so. Blackout really kind of gives me that competitive fix. Regular multiplayer just does not do it anymore. I don't know what it is, but I just get bored easily of regular multiplayer. I guess maybe I want more tense situations or something. I don't know. But that's how I feel, guys. Please tell me your thoughts about this down below in the comments. I'm very frustrated that league play has been delayed, but maybe everything is going to be worth the wait. We'll have to wait and see what happens, guys. Thanks for watching. I love y'all so much. Don't forget to leave a like on the video if you guys did enjoy. And thanks for watching. Till next time, I'll see you later.